Welcome to the Automation Zone, a video series brought to you by Miracle's RPA Center of Excellence.
Hi, this is Usha Kiranmay Gonula, working as RPA developer in Miracle Innovation Labs. Today, I would like to give a demo on SAP HR module using IBM RPA. The main theme behind this demo is to reduce the burden of entering the details of selected employees in SAP during hiring process. Regarding IBM RPA, we will see what it is and how it is useful towards in further slides. These are the topics which I'm going to cover in this video. Is automation necessary? Exploring cognitive process automation, IBM RPA overview, and how it is useful in real life, architectural flow, and live demo for automating SAP HR module with IBM RPA. Now let us move on to our first slide. Is automation necessary? Want to go for repetitive tasks which wrap up literally 50 to 70 hours per day? Sometimes wants to make less human interaction to perform the task, and sometimes you want to do continuously monitoring and generating the reports of 24/7. In these cases, we mainly need automation. The importance of automation can be clearly explained using the above example, generating an email. In this, we have two processes, manual and automation. In manual, the user generates an email, and in automation, the robot generates an email. If user wants to generate a single mail, then we go for manual process. That's expected. But what about the case if the user wants to generate multiple emails? Then I go for automation process, which greatly reduces my time. As we know that we mainly focus on less time and work, those can be achieved using this automation. I hope you got the importance of automation. Let us move on to our next slide. Exploring cognitive process automation. And thus, initially, we have robotic process automation that is mainly used for repetitive tasks, which we discussed previously. In this, we have two types, rule-based automation, which executes repeatable tasks and requires no human expertise. The example for this is generating an email, which we've seen in previous slide. And knowledge-based automation, which executes tasks that requires human expertise. The example for this is we can take real-time scenarios, like the robot is dancing, robot is cooking. So these are all come under the knowledge-based automation, which requires the robot to be expertized. Then we have conversational chatbots, which understands natural language. So we prefer coding to communicate with bots and to serve their requests. Finally, the automation anywhere, UiPath, IBM, these are all the tools of robotic process automation, and Amazon Alexa, IBM, these are all the tools of conversational chatbots which require the bots to be developed. So let us move on to the next slide, IBM RPA overview. IBM RPA automates the repetitive tasks which free up employees to perform higher value work. Before moving further, we will see why we call it as IBM RPA. Previously, we used to call it as Automation Anywhere, and recently IBM got mingled up with Automation Anywhere and released a new product called IBM RPA, which we are using now. We'll see how it helps to us. It greatly reduces our time, human error, increases our speed of work, reduces the internal and external resources. Now let us see what are the components required to work with IBM RPA. These are the three main important components, bot creators, control room, and bot runners. To work with IBM RPA, we need two main important things. The very first one is bot creators and the control room. Control room provides the current status of your environment, like how many tasks you have been scheduled, how many tasks are pushed into the control room. Whereas the bot creators is useful to create your bots by recording or by writing the logics, whatever. And bot runners is used to run your bots by scheduling at a particular time. Now let us move on to our next slide, IBM RPA in real life. So these are the areas where the IBM RPA comes into picture. Finance, banking, retail, textile, hospitality, and insurance. So for example, if you take banking, we have lot many withdrawals and the deposits, which is a repeatable task. So in those cases, we can use this IBM RPA. And in retail and textiles, we can generate the invoice bills automatically using this IBM RPA. And in hospitality, we can provide the medical bills to the patients based upon the treatment we provided to them. And whereas in insurance, we have a lot more repetitive tasks like updating the profiles, deleting the profiles, and entering the new profile, entering the details of new profile. So these can be automated using this IBM RPA. So let us move on to the next slide. So here is the architectural flow. Initially, the HR sends an email to the SAP. So the whole one is the automation process. Now, when a SAP team receives email from the HR. They will start getting the details from the database, now copies into CSV file and log on to SAP GUI. Now the robot checks if a row exists in a CSV file. If it's so, then it enters the details in SAP and append the employee ID column at the last in CSV file. And if a row doesn't exist in a CSV file, then the robot saves the CSV file and closes the SAP GUI. Now, finally, the SAP team sends email to the HR team that their work is done. And now HR team sends emails to the different employees, those who are selected, indicating that their onboarding procedure is successfully completed. So these are all the automatically done by the robot. We'll see in the next slide. Let's see the live demo of SAP HR process using IBM RPA. So initially we have created four Gmail IDs. The very first one indicates Gmail ID for SAP team, and second one for human resource, and third one for one of our employee, hired employee, and fourth one is another hired employee. So these are the mail IDs we created for automation. So let us go for automation now. Let us run our task. So initially the automation starts from getting an email to SAP team from the HR team. So after getting an email, they will get the details from the database into the CSV file and they start logging into the SAP GUI. So this all the process will be done by the robot. So as we trained previously in automation anywhere. Now it starts entering the employee details in SAP. Personal agent of it searches for the city, that is Frankfurt. We can search by either name or by ID. This is the employee group and another one is employee subgroup. So most of the cases in SJP will depend upon the ID. So everything will have an ID. So in most cases it picks up the ID rather than names. So this is the first window. It successfully saves that data and it moves to the second window. So these are all the windows which I don't need necessary, so I am skipping those windows and the robot moves further. So if we think that we don't need the data which is present in that window, we can skip that window. There are a lot more windows present in this, maintaining the data of employee. So it takes a bit of time to enter the details. After entering a first record, it will check whether the next row exists in CSV file or not. So if it exists, then it appends the last two columns of the particular employee as entered and employee ID of the employee. Now it turns to again SAP GUI to enter the details of second employee. So the same process as we've seen previously. In Automation Anywhere, what we call this in IBM RPA, with Automation Anywhere, we can see the runtime at the right-hand side. So it was showing that which number is executing and what we have mentioned in that, whether it is delay or object cloning. So these are all the commands in IBM RPA. So this will be helpful when we get an error message that we can find out that at what instant of line number we are getting the error message. So this will might helpful in those cases. It will also shows at particular instant at what line the robot is executing. So now it successfully enters the second record. It opens the CSV file and appends the two columns. So now it checks for the next record. If it doesn't exist, then it simply saves and closes the CSV file and as well the SAP GUI. So let us check our email IDs initially. SAP team will get an email from the Schumer resource. You can see there, they send in one simple statement like, please enter the employee details in SAP. So this is the statement which we got from the human resource, that is HR team. And next one is, after completion of the process, again, the SAP team sends an email to the HR team along with the attachment of CSV file. So we can download that. Let us have a quick look at the CSV file. So this is the CSV file. Previously, what we've seen along with the two appended columns of employee records. So the next one is one of our employee. So they got emailed from the human resource saying that their onboarding procedure is successfully completed along with their employee ID. And another employee also got the same email from the human resource saying that their procedure is successfully completed along with their employee ID. So this is the automation of SAP HR process using IBM RPA. Now let us see how many hours we can save with automation. So let us consider the time taken to enter the details in SAP for each selected employees. So for manual process, it takes 15 minutes, and for automation, it equals to 1 minute. Now, let us also consider we are having a per hour rate of $80 for the onboarding team members so that we can calculate the total cost savings for this RPA. So here are the calculations for the total onboardings for 52 weeks. We have 7,800. Oh, it's great. Let's see the difference between the manual and the automation processes. So this is the time taken to enter the details using this manual process is 117,000 minutes, and for automation it only takes 7,800 minutes. You can see the difference between that. And the total hours saved by this automation is 1,820 hours. And the total cost savings is $145,600 per year. Oh, it's really great. So what waiting for? Let us move on to this IBM RPA. Thank you.
Thank you for watching The Automation Zone, a video series brought to you by Miracles RPA Command Center. For more about automation, please visit miraclesoft.com/RPA.